Hello, my name is Joseph Daniel Mutambo. So I will be with you today in this topic of work statistics. So let's start with application of statistics in geographies. So first of all, you have to understand what is a statistic. When we say statistic, it means what? But there is the key terms which, when you remember it, it means you will define the term statistic. So simply, we say that statistics, this is a science. It is a science of correcting. You have to correct. Of analyzing, interpreting, storing, and organizing data in a clear and understandable way by the use of numbers. So simple, we say that is a statistic. But when you say correcting, means you correct data from the field. Analyzing, the word analyzing means in the process of summarizing the data which is already collected. So when you summarize, means you make a data analysis. But also you have to know how to interpret such data. You can interpret data through different graphs, charts, and so on. Also, to store. Storing comes from the word store. You have to store data. Also, there is a different way of storing data. One of it is graphs. You can use a graph. You can use a charts, and so on. And organizing data in a clear and understandable way. That is the simple definition of statistics. But the major term here, we say it is a data. Now, what is the data? What is the data? So simply, we can say that data is a collected information at a particular area. So we can collect data from any areas. But we have the sources of statistical data. Now, what are the sources of statistical data? Normally, we have two sources of statistical data. The first one, we have a primary data, a primary source. And the second one, we have a secondary source. But when we talk about the primary source, we say that these are the original data. Or we can say these are the first-hand data, which have never been collected by another person except you. And there is a different way of collecting this primary source or primary data. You can collect it by using various methods, like observation. Through observation, you can obtain the primary data. Or by questionnaire, also by interview. So all of these are the sources of statistical data. So we have two, remember. We have the primary source and also we have the secondary source. But simply when we say secondary source means what? Secondary source, we can say this is the second hand data. Remember in primary we say that these are the original data or first hand data, which have never been collected by another person. But when we talk about secondary data, we say this is the second-hand data. It means the data which is already collected by another researchers. For example, you can obtain the data from the magazine, you can obtain the data from TV programs, whatever the case. That such data is already collected by another person, it's already represented there. But you take it, so when you take it, we call it secondary data. Okay, so this is the secondary data. So it says that secondary data, these are the second-hand data, the data which is already collected by other researchers. So as I've already explained there, it's the data which you found in all the books, books, reports, TV program, magazines, and so on. But also we have types of statistics. Normally we have two types of statistics. So the first type of statistics we call it descriptive statistics. Now, what is a descriptive statistic? The word descriptive comes from the word describe, descriptive. It's a type of statistic which helps us to describe, to show, or to summarize the data in a meaningful way. It does not help us to draw conclusions. So you cannot draw conclusions in descriptive statistics. Okay, so another type of statistic, it is called inferential statistic. So you have to know also what is the inferential statistic. Inferential statistics simply says that is a type of statistics which lie under the probability. It means it's a type of statistics which deals with uncertain events. We just need a sample from inferential statistics. That's why it says that it is a type of statistics which allow us to use a sample to make a generalization. It's the only type of statistics which we can mark a conclusion. You can conclude because we need only a sample. For example, we have an example here. If you need to collect maybe the population of a certain place, population from, so we just take a sample of wheat. So we take a simple sample, then you deal with a sample to pay a conclusion. For example, maybe if you need to find the total number of students in a school, you can go, you can start with Form 1A maybe. You can take, maybe you can count the number of students, you'll have maybe 40 students. Form 1B, maybe 45. So Form 1C and the other classes, you can just predict. So that predictive data is called uncertainty data, which lie under the type of statistic, which is called inferential. Then let's move us directly to the nature of the statistical data. So we can say nature of statistical data, or we can say types of statistical data. Now, what is the nature of statistical data? So we have different nature of statistical data, or we have different types of statistical data. The first one, we have a discrete data. Now, what is the discrete data? What is the discrete data? Discrete data is the data which is collected in terms of all numbers. The data which you can, we can make a distinct, or you can separate such data is called a discrete data. So if you remember maybe whole numbers, you can remember the definition of discrete data. It's the data which is collected in terms of whole numbers. And if you remember it, mathematically whole numbers are actually start from zero. When you start from 0, 1, 2, and so on, that is the whole number. So this data is the data which is collected in terms of whole number. So the other types of statistical data, or nature of statistical data, we have continuous data. So the word itself, it tells us continuous. Continuous means proceeding. So continuous data, this is the data which lie within a certain intervals. So we say that is any data which lie within infinity and in infinite intervals. That's called a continuous data. Another types of data, we have individual data. Also individual data, the very individual itself tells us individual. So individual data is the type of data which exactly value for a specific item. Or we can call a specific data. Normally it deals with a specific item. So it says that it's the type of data in which exact value for a specific item are quoted. For example, the marks of every student in a class. That is individual data. That is individual data. So it touches every student. Another type of data, we have grouped data. Now, grouped data, when we say grouped data, this is a type of data which have a certain intervals. Grouped data is the data which have a certain intervals. So in a grouped data, it says that a statistical data in which no exact value which are quoted. So this is just a vice versa with individual data. So this is the data which lie under a certain class. That's why sometimes we call it a class interval. For example, if you have this class, we have a frequency also. The class of 0 up to 4 numbers. So frequency, it means the total number of that interval. The number between 0 up to 4, it is 16. That is the frequency. We have 5 up to 9. We have 6 numbers from 5 up to 9. That is the frequency. We have 10 up to 14. It is 12 numbers, so that is the frequency. So when we talk about a grouped data, it means we talk about a class interval. So when we say class interval, it means we deal with this interval. So 0 up to 4, that is the first class. 5 up to 9, that is the second class. 10 up to 14, that is the third class. But also, in this grouped data, we have different terms which can be used in the grouped data. For example, when we take this 0, number 0, when we take number 5, when we take number 10, this it is kind of a lower limit. But when we take this 4, when we take 9, sorry, and 14, this is called the upper limit. So in a grouped data, remember we have upper limit, also we have lower limit. But also we have lower real limit. Why we call lower real limit? Lower real. Real, it means there is no errors when you collect data. So it is called lower real limit because when you subtract 0.5 from the data. So that 0.5, we assume it is not an error to the data. So when you subtract it, we call it lower real limit. But also upper legal limit is the upper limit after adding 0.5 on such that. So we proceed with that content of equity data. So next period we will proceed with statistical measure, what we call measure of central tendency.